Renee, you've been singing for 3 years and you're only 20 and you've already made it fairly big. How did you get going in the beginning?
Well, I've always sort of wanted to be a singer, I guess, you know. And I think, actually, a friend of mine sort of had a couple of friends that were in a band when we were all about 16. And I went along to the rehearsal just to watch, you know. It was really exciting. And I sang a song and it was just, I don't know, I just sort of started singing with them, you know. It happened really, really quickly, everything. It's just sort of
been. You didn't sort of have training and sing in the school choir and
Not at that stage, no. No, I didn't really think about that then.
And so what happened then?
And then I was with them for about, that band, for about 6 months in little wine bars and things. And then I got into a band called Sun, and that was fantastic. It was good for me then, and I got a lot of sort of jazz background through that band, and just sort of went like that. Some people heard me when I was with them, and I joined another band and another band. And
now you're with Mother Earth.
Mother Earth, yeah, that's fantastic.
What strikes a lot of people about you is the amazing amount of confidence you have for a 20-year-old. How did you get that? Have you always been a confident person?
No, I don't. I don't think so. I'm quite paranoid. But when I sing something, I forget for that minute, you know. And then when I stop singing, I'm paranoid again. So it's really just when I'm singing that I forget about the people. Oh, you know, not, you know, just the nerves and everything.
Does sex appeal sort of play a very important part in your performance at all?
I guess so. I guess it does, you know. I mean, you know, I guess having rather large boobs helps a little bit. I don't know, but it's, I don't know. I don't really think so, no. I'm still paranoid, you know, on stage, you know, when I'm not, when I'm just looking at the audience, I feel a bit, you know. But, I guess it helps maybe a little bit.
You're planning on going overseas very soon. Do you think you have to go overseas to make it, or are you just going over for experience?
Well, I intend to go over, save enough money to just go over and watch for about 6 months or something, just absorb and listen to people, because I haven't really, I mean, I've got records, but it's not enough, really. I want to look and watch them and touch them and see how they live and everything.
Now, you just put out an LP a while ago. What kind of music was on there?
Van Morrison's song and Bill Withers and Thelma Houston. But at the time that I was offered that, I wish it was now, because I wasn't that serious, you know, then. And when I actually put it down in the studio, I wasn't singing thinking somebody's going to be putting it on the record player and, you know, sitting there stoned and going to think, oh, yeah. You know, I wasn't thinking that. I was just sort of singing. It was a session, you know. I'm really sorry that I didn't think more seriously about it at that stage.
You've recently been voted the top female singer of the year by quite a lot of rock musos. How did you feel? Were you very surprised about
that? Fantastic. That was great. I got the shock of my life, actually, because I didn't even think I was going to be nominated, because I've never been really involved with GoSet or any of those people. And it was fantastic. I felt really great.